Let's study another case of grouping of cells, that is parallel combination of cells. Let's first analyze the parallel combination of two cells in same polarity terminals of battery connected to each other, like the situation I am drawing here. Say two cells are having their EMFs E1 and E2 and internal resistance R1 and R2, and they are connected in parallel fashion as we can see here in figure. Then in this situation, if we wish to find out the equivalent battery and equivalent internal resistance for this situation, it can be replaced like this. This will be an R equivalent and this will be E equivalent connected across the terminal A and B. Here, this equivalent battery is such that the open circuit potential difference across terminals A and B must be equal to E equivalent, and this R equivalent we can directly consider the parallel combination of resistances R1 and R2, because here E1 and E2 are ideal batteries which are having zero internal resistance as far as ideal battery is concerned. So, across terminals A and B, only R1 and R2 are connected in parallel combination. So, in this situation, we can directly write R equivalent as R1 in parallel combination with R2, that can be written as R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. And for E equivalent, we can consider, say, if terminal B is on the low potential side, here we consider zero potential. And say terminal A is the high potential side, here we consider potential to be X. Then we can say in this situation the value of equivalent must be equal to X, because the open circuit potential difference across this combination is X minus 0, and here it is equivalent minus 0, or it is equivalent only. So to calculate X, we can write KCL equation for X. As in this junction we are talking about open circuit, so no current will be flowing through the terminal A, but there are two currents going in this direction, where we can say here potential will be X minus E1, and at this terminal potential will be X minus E2. So for these two branches, we can write the total outgoing currents in the direction away from the junction will be X minus E1 by R1 plus X minus E2 by R2 should be equals to 0. On solving, we are getting the value of X is equals to E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 upon 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So this can be considered as the equivalent EMF for the combined cell, which can be replaced in position of these two cells in parallel combination. So here we can write the value of E equivalent will be E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 divided by 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, and R equivalent we can directly write as R1 in parallel combination with R2, which we already obtained. And the same can be generalized for N cells connected in parallel combination. Here we can say for N cells in parallel, or we can directly use, we just generalize the relation as E equivalent, as in this situation it will be E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 plus and so on up to N times. But you must be very careful, if there is one cell which is oppositely connected, then we must use a negative sign with that cell's EMF. And in denominator, it will be 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus and so on. It will always be positive, so it will be up to 1 by Rn. And here one more thing which is important to be understood, that is, if all cells are identical of EMF E and internal resistance R, then in this situation you can see, if we take all EMF equals to E, here E can be taken out and numerator denominator gets cancelled out, and equivalent EMF can be written as same as that of an individual cell. So you must keep one thing in mind, if N identical cells are connected in parallel, the equivalent EMF will remain same, and equivalent internal resistance can be written as all resistances connected in parallel. So that can be taken as R by N only. So here you can see if N identical cells are connected in parallel, equivalent EMF never changes, but the equivalent internal resistance decreases. That means the current capacity of individual cells increase in parallel combination.